you so much for joining us today. This is our first after-school performance of My Time as a Drama Teacher, and it is truly an honor to work with such passionate and hardworking students. Come just an incredibly cohesive ensemble this semester, so we're really, really excited to share these three mystery-themed short plays with you all. Please make sure to freely laugh, cry, and applaud. The students overcome a lot of challenges in this rehearsal process with like theater stars having their tech week this semester and testing coming in at the end of the year. Some days there have been like only the 6th and 7th graders here, everyone except Zoe, she's the only 6th grader in the class. So they have overcome a lot of challenges in this rehearsal process. They do have some transitions that might take a few moments, so just be patient with us. Our performance is being recorded by Mr. Jim, so please silence your cell phones, refrain from any flash photography, and please take any fussy audience members outside. But most importantly, enjoy the show.
On the theater.
I'm scared, Mama.
Don't be scared, baby. We'll protect you.
Yes, we'll protect you.
What? They're just Mama.
Hey, guys. What's happening?
You made this mess?
Wait a minute.
Naughty chipmunks.
It wasn't us.
It wasn't.
Something bigger than a silly chipmunk.
Hey, man. We're not silly. We're the real deal.
What's real deal?
We are, baby. We're smooth and cool. We're happening. We're the realest deal there is.
You're a menace.
But the cat will catch us if we eat on the ground.
It must go up.
But if it goes up, I can't eat without knocking it down again.
Aha! We help Bear put it up.
But then how will she eat it?
I
got it.
What?
When we eat, we drop a lot of seeds.
Yes?
Let's invite her to below us while we eat.
Oh!
And I'll keep the cat away.
You can do that?
Yeah, the cat's afraid of me.
Hooray!
A win-win for everyone.
Bear, you're the real deal.
Welcome to the theater.
We're glad you're here.
Thank you all very much.
Cold.
Cold case. Didn't the murder just happen?
What time did the murder happen?
I don't know.
You don't know. You make a horrible witness.
I didn't witness anything.
Then who are you?
I'm the mayor's cousin. I'm just visiting for the weekend.
In what way?
In what way what?
Like, how are you cousins? Are you related?
Yeah, we're cousins.
Oh, so in the regular way. So you were saying you found the body last night?
No, I never said that.
I thought you said that. Why are you making things up? Telling me that the murder just happened?
No. I heard there was an art fair that happened yesterday or something that ended at 5, and you said that the body was found this morning, so I just figured it had to happen in between the two.
I think you're onto something. Good work. Keep it going.
Wait, you're the sheriff. Shouldn't you be the one to...
I told you, this case has gone cold. We've hit a dead end, and I have no idea why she is dead. And we have nothing to go on. And if we have nothing to go on, then we have no place to start. I have no idea why Edward is dead.
You know their name?
Yeah, that's Edward Sims. He's the town butcher.
So you do know something about the victims?
Well, I don't know why he was killed, if that's what you mean. And I don't know who killed him. But if there was someone who wanted him dead, and if I really knew the guy, I probably would know who that was. And I don't. So I guess I really don't know anything about Edward. I'm sure I speak for the entire town. How grateful we are that you're going to investigate. You said you were a private investigator.
No, I never said that.
Well, great. Well, good luck. If I were you, I would start with Jonathan. Jonathan probably did it.
Jonathan? Wait, Sheriff.
Did you find the killer? Was it Jonathan?
No. What I wanted to point out were the victim's feet. Do you see them?
Yeah, I see... 2. Is that how many you see?
Yes, but it's not the number of feet. It's that they're barefoot, right? You see that? They got pants, a long sleeve shirt, a jacket, but no shoes or socks. Don't you find that odd?
Edward never wore socks.
Ever?
No, never.
How do you know?
That's Edward Sims, the town butcher.
Didn't his feet get cold?
No, if it was cold out, he wore boots.
Boots without socks?
Yes.
Why?
Why what?
Why didn't Edward wear socks?
Because he didn't like socks.
Yeah, what didn't he like about them? Like,
he didn't like wearing them.
Well, yeah, but like, why didn't he like wearing them?
Because he didn't have socks.
And that's the reason Edward never wore socks, because he didn't have them?
Have what?
Socks.
Well, a person can't wear something they don't have. Do you think that's why he was killed? Because he didn't own any socks?
I can't imagine that would be a motive for murder, but I guess anything's possible.
Keep up the good work. You would be a great FBI agent. If you solve this case, it would sure look good to the Bureau.
I'm not a FBI agent whatsoever.
What? I thought you said that. No shame. No shame to be low ranking. Well, good luck. And if I were looking into this, it'd be Jonathan. Jonathan killed him.
Who's Jonathan?
It was Jonathan.
What? No, who's Jonathan?
Everyone, this weekend has to be perfect. Make sure it is.
Absolutely.
Cook, how is the menu coming?
Fantastic as usual.
Of course. Of course. Yes, it would be. Janet.
Yes?
See to it that everyone has what they need in their rooms.
Right away.
This must be my best party ever. Oh, the first victim. I mean, guest.
Hello, hello. So wonderful to see you. Simply charming. So glad to be invited to your party. Again. You can never have too much meat, can you?
Let me take your coat. And your,
Oh, yeah. I forgot. I got a dog. Isn't she just a sweetie? Her name is Kittens. Here you go. Well, she's a bit tired, but I'll be all.
I'll have Janet see you to your room. Janet!
Here.
Make sure Queenie here gets the best room in the house.
Of course, right away.
You always take such good care of me. By the way, who else is coming?
Oh, you'll see. It's a very special party this time.
So exciting. I love surprises.
Maybe not this one, however. Hello there. Oh, you both came at the same.
Why did you lure me to this godforsaken place? I mean, really.
Whatever do you mean?
I didn't think I'd be stuck here with him, for instance.
What scared pretty face are you?
Oh, you know him?
Oh, no. Never seen him before in my life.
Great place you got here. Anytime I go to the country, it makes me sneeze. I must be allergic to nature. Ha, get it?
I'm gonna kill you before this weekend is over.
Not so fast. Someone else might take care of that for you.
What did you say?
Oh, nothing. Head right that way to find your rooms.
Should we tell ghost stories tonight? This place is so creepy. I have some incredible ghost stories. If you'll please share them. Once upon a time...
I'm here. Great. I think someone's at the door. Do your thing and play the part.
Got it.
Hello.
Hello. I just got back to Columbia. I hope I'm not too late.
No, we knew you'd be a bit late.
Wait, how did you know that?
We have our ways. Please come in. Your room's upstairs. Come in. We were expecting you.
You were you? You go first, Rosa.
Thank you. My house.
Oh, it's not my house. I just work for the owner.
Still, yeah, it is called this.
I read about this house once. Is it some sort of historical property?
Yes.
I can take your coat.
I prefer to keep mine, thanks.
Can I take your bags?
I like to keep a hold of my things.
Well, well, you seem to be nervous all of a sudden.
I'll show you both to your rooms. Let's see. We should have two more people. Oh, here they are.
I can't believe I decided to come here this weekend.
I'm very glad you did. Come in.
I was just saying how quiet it is in the country.
We weren't talking, like, at all, but whatever.
Oh, is this fruit fresh?
What? No, it's wax. Just decoration. I'll show you both to your rooms.
Okay, whatever.
Where did she go?
I don't know and I don't care.
Well, she'll find her room eventually. Come with me. Time to start the party.
I haven't seen the host or the helper anywhere. Have you?
Come to think of it, you're right. I haven't seen either.
We can't go outside.
Obviously not. It's raining.
The drinks are really good, though, wouldn't you say?
No, I would not say. Where is our host anyway?
Right here. Sorry, our afternoon walk got canceled because of the rain.
Oh yes, Kibbles and I were so disappointed. Kibbles must have her walk, you know. But in my mansion, we can give Kibbles a good walk in my tennis courts.
Your tennis courts, huh? Whom did you say you were here?
Queenie, have you heard of me?
Well, I've heard of you, all right.
What do you mean by that?
Nothing.
Tommy, come now before it gets cold.
Nice touch.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing.
I'm getting a little freaked out by the way the cook is looking at us.
Me too.
Oh, hello there. Is it dinner time already?
Yeah.
Aw, look at all of you here. It's dinner time, right?
Yeah.
That girl's a head case.
Why can't we all just get along?
Hello, everyone. I hope you enjoyed your meal. Cook made it especially for you all, with all of your individual taste in mind. So, are we ready to have dessert, or...?
All right, I'm sick of all this game playing. What's going on here?
I'm sorry, I must go. Something has come up.
You literally...
Thank you, Cook. It should only be a minute. Cook, if you'll be so kind as to serve dessert.
You saw nothing!
Wait, where is everyone?
What do you mean? We're all here.
She's right. The host, the cook, and the helper are missing.
Oh, hey, the lights are on! I'm hungry. When do we eat?
Dinner was an hour ago. Look, everyone, I'm sure the staff will return soon. What's a big deal anyway?
It's missing!
Of course it is!
Why do you say it like that? Do you have my necklace?
Why would you say that?
Well, you are sitting right next to me.
What does that have to do with anything?
Maybe you did take the necklace.
Calm down, children. We'll find the people and your necklace, too.
Yes! We can!
Who are you?
I've been hired to solve the mystery!
Which one?
Both of them. Until I do, no one is leaving this house.
Seriously, I have to be in Dubai in 2 days.
I can't stay here. It is too small.
Whatever.
Sounds fascinating. Can I help?
I just have to go upstairs and check out my things.
There's going to be a thunderstorm tonight. I can feel it.
Everyone is staying right here. First, we must find the host and the staff. Then we can find your necklace.
I vote we split up. It will be faster that way.
Splitting up is never a good idea. Don't you read mystery novels?
I read all of the classics.
That's a no.
I can't stay here. It is hot. I'm claustrophobic. I feel faint.
Just what we need. A drama queen.
A drama queen named Queenie. Who would have thought?
Just kill me now.
I'll take Jamal here and go to the attic.
Great. I'll take Rick and go to the kitchen.
I'll check the bedrooms of Vincent, I guess.
I'm ready and you are.
Don't make me regret my choice.
Does that mean I get to go with Tara?
And me too.
Going where?
We'll take the basement.
Meet back here in half an hour. Good luck.
I didn't! All I heard was to arrive here at a certain time. I arrived and the door is unlocked. I came into the dining room when I heard a scream.
Fascinating.
Wait, what is that?
I'm not sure. Looks like...
a knife!
The cook was holding that knife!
And now it's on the floor, huh? Well,
let's keep looking.
Rick, what is that? The cook.
Is the cook dead?
No, just sleeping. They must have been drugged.
So, now what?
Let's alert the others. Don't touch anything.
Vincent, what are you doing?
What are you talking about?
You're practically on top of me. Get away from me. Go check the other bedroom.
I'm totally fine. I'm not scared at all. Actually, this is kind of fun.
I'm having less fun by the minute. Just remember, no one can know we work together.
Yes, I know. I won't tell a soul.
What is that?
It's the helper!
Is she dead?
But she doesn't look good.
What should we do?
We need to alert the detective. I don't want to get involved in this.
I'm already on my way. This place gives me the creeps.
So, why'd you say we have to search the attic?
It's the least likely place anyone would have gone.
Okay. We saw it. Can we go now?
Wait. I see something shiny.
The necklace! We are so far away!
That's the first time I've seen you interested in anything. Are you sure you don't know more about it?
What are you trying to say?
Nothing. Let's get back to the detective.
I can't leave this place fast enough!
Basements are always so dark and low.
I want to get out of here.
Wait, there's something interesting about that shape.
I do not care about shapes, especially interesting ones.
But this one looks familiar.
It's the host!
Well, she's alive, or seems to be.
I'm so out of here.
I wonder where that door leads to.
Let's not find out, shall we? Let's
I'm
go.
Ready ahead of you.
I don't know what they're talking about.
Didn't you hire me, though?
Oh, yes, but not to solve the mystery.
Well, then what do you need me here for?
We needed you here so that we could catch you.
Catch me during what?
I'm actually the head police chief in town. We've been hearing about a run of thefts in the area, and I just had a hunch.
Yes, in every theft, you were the head detective on the case.
And in every theft, the items were never found.
We had a hunch that your growing fortune and the unsolved cases were linked.
Wait, so you were in on this too?
We worked with the host and the helper to get you over here.
By luring with the theft, just like your other unsolved mysteries.
Since I had the jewels,
we thought that was a bigger crime for you to commit.
But, I don't know what you mean!
How about opening your jacket then?
But it's evidence!
With your fingerprints.
I never touched it.
This is madness!
How'd I do? You did super, my friend.
Thanks.
I still have no idea about any of this. I just had to make a meal.
And to put sleeping potions in all of their drinks.
What do you mean? I would never.
But you did.
You were in on it with the detective.
Fine. The tip that gives me the money from the made from the sales. Happy?
Very.
Why you?
Nice work, everyone.
Dessert?
Yes.
After they clean up, but...